第二十七队演讲题目是 Number Three， 计时开始。
As technology advances and science progresses, our life has become more easier than it used to be. However, the good intentions to make humans live better has also turned sour. When we expected the internet to shrink the distance between people,We ended up having internet scams causing people to disbelieve one another. When we wanted home appliances to make us enjoy the overseas product or produce in a blink of an eye, we, humans, eventually become the one which made global warming to become worse. When we look forward to experiments conducted in a science lab, bring quality living for us,All the issues we have gotten is like food insecurity, immorality, and a lack of human conscience.
Among all international issues presented above, our group feels that people in Taiwan should be more concerned about food safety issues worldwide. We should do what we can to help better the situation we are facing now. As residents of the Earth,We feel we're obligated to do something to help. On the one hand, we should establish non-governmental organizations to monitor food management, rather than rely on the government alone. On the other hand, we should resort to our conscience, so that we won't process food which is not healthy for humans to consume. Some examples of dangerous food items are pesticides in baby formula and many bottled drinks, copper chlorophyll in olive oil,garlic oil used in producing cooking oils, artificial flavoring used in making bread, soup stocks, pastries, and many other foods and drinks that are closely associated with people's daily needs.
We feel worried and suspicious when we hear words like chemical, artificial, and processed. In this special time, it is not enough to only rely on the government to help manage the whole food safety regulation.We as citizens should stand up, establish organization, and set up our own strict rules to ban those unqualified food from being shoved in supermarket. One good example is Italy. Being economically depressed for years, they regained their ground through a very thorough and strict food monitoring food system design and predicted by a non-governmental organization, which even opened a chain supermarket called Italy, starting with E and sound exactly like the name of their country.This chain only sells product and produce which has passed their own certification and inspections. Unlike most stores, Italy destroys items 5 days before their expiration date, which avoid customers eating food without freshness. Because these food safety regulations are set up by non-governmental organizations, they can stand in consumer shoes and better monitor food items for us and keep us from foodborne illnesses.
Food safety management system is a set of food safety guidelines set up for food producers and growers to follow. However, while price and basic quality remains important, producers and growers' morality will be challenged. Most of the time, they will relish the benefits than their own conscience. So, instead of using natural ingredients, they will use artificial ones, which will thus harm consumer health in the end.In this case, our group believes Taiwan should start educating children of the importance of consuming healthy food, and the consequence that food produced by adding illegal additives will bring to our body. Only by understanding of food safety and the disadvantage that being immoral could do great harm to the human body, then our next generation will be able to make correct choice when they grow up.Good conscience is a soft pillow. We believe good concepts should be passed down to our country's future, our kids, and that they will want to be better futures for us.
Food safety issue is the one which influences people directly. So we strongly suggest that Taiwanese people should stand up for our own sake.Start to do something instead of waiting our government to solve the problems for us. Teaching our next generation how to make good food choices and stay clear conscious when he or she is getting involved in food business. And those above illustrations are things we need to do immediately.
1, 2.
Thank you.
第26对演讲题目是 Number 5, 计时开始.
Good morning, honorable judges. Human societies have been established closer and closer together. Thanks to technology and communication and transportation, the world has been connected to a global village. But Taiwan, under the pressure of our giant neighbor, China, that can always get away into interacting with other countries in a dominant way. Many countries also jump onto the arena of the world. But what about Taiwan? Our government then urges the youth to widen their vision by providing students with exchange program in university, government fellowship for studying abroad. But it all costs a lot. So how to develop our teenagers' global perspective without lots of money seems to be an important question to think about.
Take myself for example. This July, at Taichung First Senior High School, I joined Model United Nations for the first time. In the conference, the high school students are put in a position of government ministers or delegates. Here, we don't represent ourselves. We speak on a specific topic on behalf of a foreign country. In this way, teenagers can learn to think through global lenses. This provides students with knowledge of contemporary international issues, such as free trade, terrorism, and the effects of globalization. Moreover, we can develop skills in research, negotiation, critical thinking, diplomacy, and persuasion. In Model UN, young people work through problems firsthand in the same way as world leaders do. Also, through this meeting, I learned not only my competence in English has much to be desired, but also that teenagers can have better understanding of international issues, relation topics by group discussion and debates.
Stacy, thanks for your sharing. I believe too that developing the global perspective doesn't need to cost big bucks. The Taiwan International Youth Exchange Association has provided cultural exchanges within easy reach. It invites foreign friends to attend summer camps in Taiwan. This provides valuable opportunities for us to experience Western culture, enhance our English language skills, and to make foreign friends without exorbitant traveling expenses. The government strives to help us keep abreast of international affairs. However, are we ready yet? To prepare a world we will inherit, we should equip the global perspectives and the ability to harness them. In other words, when we learn English, we have the access to the culture of English-speaking countries. When we study geographical and historical background of this country, we have much more thought of this country.
However,
cultivating global perspective needs long-term efforts. One step at a time, small steps can make a person difference. As for me, expecting myself to be to have international perspectives. I enjoy international events very much. I've made the rules to watch CNN and listen to ICRT when I have free time. From these channels, not only do I get to know international events, but I can also know how the people in the countries find out how the people in these countries perceive this event. I start to redefine this world with a global mindset.
Thank you.
第24队演讲题目是 Number One， 计时开始。
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Today, we would like to talk to you about the humanitarian aid Taiwan has recently provided and ways in which young people like us can help sustain this good work. First, allow me to ask you a question. Are you proud to be Taiwanese? We certainly are. Taiwan was the first nation to send emergency relief supplies and rescue workers to Japan after the disastrous earthquake of 2011. And in the year before, Taiwan sent medical aid to assist the residents of Haiti to help get the country back on its feet. Additionally, just a few months ago, Taiwanese government donated $300,000 to Nepal in the wake of their massive earthquake, which caused countless deaths and injuries.
It is not only the Taiwanese government that has made me proud to be a Taiwanese citizen. It is also all the NGOs we sponsor which help those in need. For example, World Vision is helping out Jordan, Syria, and Lebanon by offering health care, education, and clean water. Also, the Taiwanese Red Cross has built New Hope Village in Haiti, a project completed in June 2012, which offers housing and aid to thousands of Haitians. It was the first construction of its kind to be completed on the island. In addition, Red Cross Chairwoman Wang Qingfang's office is currently raising funds to provide everyday necessity to Syrian refugees, adding to the $8 million worth of relief supplies already sent by Taiwan to those displaced by the conflict in the Middle East.
So now that we know how our country contributes by offering international aid, the question remains, what can we do to make a difference within the international community? Well, for a start, we can volunteer in organizations like the Red Cross, as well as learning crucial life skills, such as first aid. We'll also be taught the importance of one of the Red Cross maxims: understanding the context of international humanitarian law while encouraging the provision of ongoing humanitarian relief whenever it is needed, wherever it is needed. Penny would now like to share a story she read just recently, which inspired her to get involved in this type of work. It started with one man, Yang Yuren.
After learning that many children in Kenya must walk barefoot for nearly 4 hours to attend school, Yan and his wife, who live in Taoyuan City, decided to launch a campaign called Used Shoes Save Lives. to encourage people to send them unwanted footwear. Within days of posting the campaign on Yon's blog and setting up the Facebook page, they had received nearly 15,000 pairs of shoes and 7 metric tons of clothes, enough to fill a 40-foot shipping container. This gave me the idea that students in school all around Taiwan could collect shoes and clothes for the needy. I believe we all have an obligation to contribute to our humanitarian aid. I hope what we have said today will encourage and motivate you to find an opportunity to assist our international community. Whether it be by joining a charitable organization or starting a campaign at your school. Thank you for your time, and remember, you can start making a difference today. Make Taiwan proud of you. Bow.
Thank you for your attention.
第22队演讲题目是 Number 5, 计时开始。
Good morning, dear judges and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen. Did you notice international news about the earthquake hit in Japan? The earthquake hit in Japan caused a very serious tsunami. And it's really a tragic that many people die from it. What's worse, it not only led to the Japanese economic decline, but also led to the nuclear plant power destroyed. Taiwan is a provider of humanitarian aid. As long as we know this news, we started to do some things to help them. First, Ministry of Foreign Affairs and other government agencies, they contribute a lot of money to help them rebuild their economy. Second, we dispatched our rescue teams to help them rebuild their hometown. Third, we assisted domestic and foreign national to help them evacuate. Due to our assistance, the whole world realized that Taiwan is not enthusiastic, but also generous. And how can we do to help the world? Although we are just students, we also can do some things to make a difference to change the world. We can also pay a little money to help them.
Well, not only Japan, inclusive of the earthquake of Haiti, Honduras, and Dominican Republic, Taiwan is also positive to supply the emergency aid. We supply them the new mapping technology, and also we created a platform which experts will show their experience in it and also can exchange the ideas due to the disaster. Although we have many disadvantages in the international relationships, Taiwan's performance in this area still gains a lot of praise in the globe.
As the students in Taiwan, how can we do to get involved in this work? We think the most necessity problem for them is financial needs. We can use crowdfunding sites such as Kickstarter to raise money. In another ways, we can even get money through school fair or collections of receipts.
But if just a few people care about this issue, our fundraising will be in a slow rate. So strengthening public awareness is also the thing we have to do. Well, there are many ways we can express our appeals through the school club or newspapers and even magazines. We can also use the social media like Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. In such many ways, we can publicize our thoughts and also educate the public. the importance of this issue. And more people, maybe they were willing to help us.
And if you think that all these methods are too difficult or complicated, there's also an easier way to prove your concern. That is donating old clothes or books. With the books and the clothing you share, the kids will not only gain the assistance, but also feel the warmth of this world.
Finally, we think the students like us, the most valuable thing is we have a strong ability to cooperate.
We can gather our school's union, created a student study organization to strengthen our thought.
And we think the key to develop a global perspective is concerned more about the global issues.
Without spending so much money, students and teachers, we should start with our education first. And I quote, "A good upbringing of the desperate mind is the greatest prize of all." So let's help teach our young generations, for
they are the leaders of tomorrow.
第二十一对演讲题目是 Number 5, 计时开始。
Good morning, everyone. As the world becomes a global village, we're all becoming closely interconnected with each other. Thus, we cannot neglect the importance of developing, individually and as a nation, a strong global perspective. The world we live in is in continual transformation, though its impact on our daily lives may not always be instantly noticeable. It is nevertheless causing a change. Seemingly, random events happen in other countries can have a real impact on our daily lives. But do we have to purchase an expensive ticket and fly to other countries to form a global perspective? Of course not. There are plentiful possibilities for us to broaden our horizons right here if we simply use our creativity.
Thanks for the introduction, Kiki. The importance of developing a global perspective can be seen in several ways. First of all, with deeper understanding of other countries, we can enhance our ability to work across countries and cultures in pursuit of a more just and sustainable world. For instance, the multi-nation Iran nuclear deal is on the verge of being signed into effect. And as President Obama said, it marks one more chapter in pursuit of a safer, more helpful, and more hopeful world. There are various factors to consider in the nuclear deal, and having a strong understanding of other countries' culture, economy, and political position is a crucial element. Furthermore, we need to create more opportunities for our country by developing a global perspective because it enhances our competitiveness. As an example, a job seeker with a global perspective built on knowledge and experience will be the more valuable to a company. As can be seen, the development of global perspective is crucial to Taiwan and its people.
Good point, Tina. The development of global perspective can be done without a large amount of money. In our school, students participated in the International Affairs Club, which is devoted to studying global issues and expanding international perspectives. We hold a debate each week to have a more accurate and multidimensional view of global issues. The debate broadens our horizons and stimulates creative thinking, providing opportunities for us to look at things in new and different ways. Furthermore, we participated in the Model United Nations conferences with other schools, and this motivates us to delve deeper into the agreement and conflicts between the interconnected states of the world. Our school's International Affairs Club even broadcasts a school radio show each week to talk about international news issues. Perhaps the most crucial element necessary to develop a global perspective is simply our passion and dedication.
On the other hand, making pen pals can be a fun and broadening experience. With our modern technology, you can now easily meet pen pals on the internet. There are certain websites customized for exactly this purpose. One is penpalworld.com, which enables you to connect with global citizens around the world. Another way is via social media. For example, last month, I made an acquaintance of a Russian girl named Polina on VK, Russia's largest social media website. We discussed the education system of our own country and also about respective culture. She gave me an insight into their education and helped me critically examine our own system. Making personal connection and developing a global perspective simultaneously is a fun way to learn more about the world and your country's role in it.
Great points, girls. Developing a global perspective can be compared to climbing a mountain, going step by step. With the accumulation of each small effort, you'll soon be viewing the world from an elevated perspective. By the time you reach the top, you'll be amazed at how broad your worldview has become. In conclusion, since the modern world is so closely connected, we need to be ready for collaborating with all global citizens. And this can be realized by the creative approaches mentioned previously. As the author Paulo Coelho said, if we understand each other better in our soul, it is easier to overcome the economic and political barriers. But first, we have to understand that our neighbor is, in the end, just like us, with the same problems, the same questions. Thank you.
第十八队演讲题目是 Number One， 计时开始。
Honorable judges, thank you for giving us this opportunity to speak with you today. We would like to talk to you about the things Taiwan has done to highlight itself as a provider of humanitarian aid, and the things that Taiwan used to have helped in this mission. We hope you enjoy our speech. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. What is a provider of humanitarian aid? It is a person or a country that is able to rescue someone who is in trouble or dying. For example, it is someone who might give the needed food or money to help them become better during a difficult time. I'd like to ask you some questions. First, do you agree that we live in a wonderful environment? If you think so, please raise your hand. Second, even though Taiwan is a small country, don't you think that it is full of enthusiasm, peace, and love? If you agree, please raise your hand again. We all agree, and we would like to share with you three examples in recent history. Let's show the ways Taiwanese people help others around the world. We have a culture of giving and helping. We would also like to share with you the benefits of being a caring society and how what goes around comes around.
A serious earthquake in Japan. 4 years ago, disrupting life throughout the country. Even compared to the 9-1 earthquake in Japan. In Taiwan, there were over 150,000 people who were forced to sleep on the street because their homes were destroyed, and 12,000 people who lost their lives. around 300 children will grow up without their parents as orphans. What did Taiwanese people do at that time? Whoever they were, all Taiwanese people had tried their best to help Japan. I still remember how my teacher held our donation box and told us, if you have ability, your money is the best way to help them. In total, people in Taiwan donated about $70 billion to Japan. It is common during a troubling time to see some organizations, such as Ciji, roaming the streets and raising money for the needy.
This past summer vacation, in Taipei's Formosa Fun Water Park, a serious accident occurred when party dust caught fire and exploded. Over 500 people were harshly burned on that day. What did the Japanese do? They donated a huge amount of artificial skin to Taiwan. A Japanese medical group came to Taiwan with artificial skin and helped to operate on the needy patients. The Earth is like a family. Each year, nonprofit organizations and the government spend lots of money to help other countries because we have both compassion and international perspective. We can give a hand to other countries when they are in need. When it comes to Taiwan, I think that foreigners will say, wow, people in Taiwan are passionate, peaceful, and friendly.
Many popular groups for young people in Taiwan have a main purpose of helping other people, such as Ciji, World Vision, Red Cross, and so on. I think young people are joining these groups to shape the future of our world to be a better one. Taiwanese youth also joined activities like 30-hour famine to raise money and awareness to fight hunger and other issues, sharing the terrible experience of those who don't have regular meals is a good way to understand how they feel. And Taiwanese are a people who can put themselves into others' shoes. Taiwanese youth show their love for the entire world every day. We are able to and do to be a big provider of humanitarian aid. When we grow up, we'll teach our children our dream of a better future. Making the world a better place is our target. By helping people all around the world, we get closer to that target and embrace our future. Thank you.
第十七队演讲题目是 Number Two， 计时开始。
Visa, import major to carry out the management of entering or leaving a country. It's also a way for a country to maintain its sovereignty, dignity, security.And benefit. So far, various kinds of visas have been developed. For instance, a tourist visa will enable student countries to have sightseeing in different countries, while students' visa will enable students to study in other countries. Though countries defend their sovereignty and benefit with various kinds of visas. In order to cope with internationalization,Each country has its own policies to allow convenience by taking majors. Among these policies, the most influential ones are visa-free, arrival visa, and electronic visa.
So now, let's talk about first part, visa-free. Is that with the development of tourism, later, in order to promote more international interaction,Each country will allow the citizens of a particular country to enter the country without visa. Furthermore, this policy can be carried out in the U.S. according to different levels of cooperation between these two countries.
First, the unconditional stay. It's common for an alliance in which countries cooperate closely and offer visa-free for the members included. The best example is the European Union.Second, abolition of visa requirements, but still limit the surgery time. This is one-to-one cooperation between two countries, such as the relationship between Taiwan and Japan. Third, unilaterally abolition of visa requirements and limit the soldier time. This is mainly practiced between two countries. One may issue the visa to the citizen of the other country. However, it doesn't happen vice versa. For instance, the mainland China declared that Japanese can enter China without visa, while the Japanese government doesn't allow the same measure to be carried out for the people from mainland China.
Second part, on arrival visa, is not required to get the visa before going abroad. Instead, all you have to do is apply visa on reaching the destination country. Comparing with the general procedure, it's easier and take less time to get this visa. Third part, electronic visa, is issued via the internet. This measure is not only beneficial for government's efficiency, but also convenient for the applicant.
Whatever the convenient measure is, we can conclude that this convenience can do more good than harm to countries involved, and the influences can range from our daily life up to the foreign relations among countries.
For our daily life, according to the above description, the convenient measures can save not only lots of time for waiting, but also lots of money for fees. In this way, traveling will be totally fun without any burden. Moreover, we can broaden our horizons on our trip to other countries. With these experiences, we can also enhance our global perspective.
For foreign relations, though Taiwan has been crowded out in the international society for a long time, each convenience measure mentioned above not only make Taiwan's status promote more and more, but also confirm our value in a different way. In this way, we can contact with the world more easily and have more interaction with each country.
To sum up, though China has played an influential role in the international society for the past two decades, there are only 30 countries practicing visa-free with China. However, Taiwan has already achieved the number up to 130 in this field.
These statistics indirectly indicate that Taiwan is a country with social orders, development, and knowledge of rules for this international society. On the other hand, by taking part in the international activities, we are proving the importance and status of Taiwan in the world.
So now, it's time for us to step further.
When we are thinking about a way to become better economically and diplomatically, we have to consider carefully how to maintain our strength, and even better.
Let's make Taiwan known in our global village. Thanks for listening.
第十五队演讲题目是 Number 4, 计时开始。
How do you take a country, its land, culture, and history, and do it justice from presenting it to people who have never been there? What does it mean to be Taiwanese? It means to begin by disabusing local students of any preconceived notions they may have of Taiwan. Like any building, you must start construction on the ground floor. First, I would distinguish between Thailand and Taiwan, two separate peoples in two separate countries, pointing out helpfully on a map that they're 2,259 kilometers away from each other. With that out of the way, I would begin by describing Taiwan as a confluence of innovation and tradition, inspired by a landscape that's breathtaking to behold. I would welcome them to Isla de Formosa, the beautiful island.
It would be good, as I got on my giant bicycle to start with Taiwan's international products. As I powered up my iPad, made by the Taiwanese company Foxconn. While waiting, I will sip my 85 degrees coffee, the Starbucks of Taiwan, and introduce them to some of the technology that makes Taiwan great. I will show them a view taken from the once tallest building in the world, Taipei 101, and show them photos of it to a mass damper made to offset the gusts from typhoons and shakes from earthquakes. Knowing the importance of the transportation in recent society, I will switch to photos of the HSR, high speed rail, and play a recording I took on my ride. But I wouldn't play long, because the recording is so silent, and explained that the train is traveling at 300 kilometers per hour as it crosses the breadth of a country in an hour and a half. Finally, I will end my trip in Tainan, one of Taiwan's earliest settlements, and start introducing the effect Taiwanese culture still has on forming the Taiwanese identity.
Here's where I will demonstrate the four treasures of study, teaching them the history along the way. The best way to show it to people will be to bring out the basic tools, a writing brush, an ink stick, paper, and an ink slab. Wherever I will go, my goals will be to teach the local students how to write Chinese calligraphy. I could show them one of the Chinese pictographs, which are drawings of the objects they represent, and tell them how those characters were formed originally. I will demonstrate a very common example, wo, which is composed of shou, hand, and ge, dagger, representing someone holding a dagger to protect himself, to fight for his own survival. So wo means me. For something that they could take on with themselves, I will have them make sky lanterns, explaining that these were originally made for use in war to summon help, but have evolved to be used in a wish ceremony where students write down their wish and set it on a journey above Taiwan's majestic landscape.
Finally, I will introduce Taiwan's stunning scenery. I will make videos of those attractions first, put them on YouTube or social website like Twitter or Facebook, which are easy for foreign students to replay to their heart desire and give feedback. While showing such places like Lugu on a projector, I will give a sample of oolong tea grown at such a place. I will introduce Kending, the most famous beach in Taiwan. We'll give them the sample of the delicious mangoes, much sweeter than the kind of varieties they could find in their countries. Lastly, I will introduce Taroko National Park and its natural gorges, while feeding them pineapple cakes that can be found nationwide and are within easy reach from any part of the island. These, I believe, will be enough to give a taste of what Taiwan has to offer.
But I would leave them wondering. 650,000 Chinese artifacts, the largest collection in the world,
with some tantalizing information.
Taiwan holds a world record for the most Little League Baseball Championship titles.
That would whet their appetites.
Over 300 night markets nationwide.
And make foreigners want to explore Taiwan for themselves. That would be my hook. After showing them what Taiwan has offered the world and giving them a feel for some of Taiwan's enduring traditions and showing them the sights, sound, and taste of authentic Taiwanese food, I wouldn't have to do anymore because they will have fallen in love with Isla de Formosa.
Thank you.
第14队演讲题目是 Number 4, 计时开始。
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Taiwan, also known as Formosa, is a beautiful mountainous island surrounded by the sea. As a famous tourist attraction in Asia, it not only beautiful landscapes and abundant natural resources, but also has advanced technology and various cultures. Firstly, we would like to show foreigners the beauty of Taiwan's scenery. The well-known landscape, like Taroko Gorge, which is famous for its marble gorge. For foreign cyclists, cycling through a gorge and enjoy the breathtaking mountain views at the same time is definitely amazing and impressive. Of course, a giant bike will be the best choice for the biking journey, because it is one of the world famous MIT brand. Summer Lake is another popular spot, integrating beautiful mountain and lake views. Taking a cable car or strolling along the lakeshore and tasting local tea and food are great ways to experience the charm of Summer Lake. Besides, for foreign swimming lovers. It is also exciting to try swimming across Summer Lake. Another popular scenery spot is Kandin. Foreigners may simply lie on the beach and relax. If they want more fun, doing water sports or exploring the undersea beauty will be the great experience.
Aside from scenery tours, foreigners may visit famous temples in Taiwan to know better about the main Taiwan religion. People in Taiwan hold an open attitude toward welcoming both Western and Eastern religions. Among them all, Taoism and Buddhism own most followers. The temple of the two religions are everywhere in Taiwan. This temple not only preserves the traditional Chinese architecture, but also displays the faith of most Taiwanese. What's more, recently, numerous creative products or performances mix modern design or traditional cultures, such as the show of electronic techno neon god, known as San Taizi in Taiwan, combines electronic music and Taoism rituals. The unique Taiwanese religious performance has earned international reputation in recent years.
With a lot of Chinese and indigenous cultures, Taiwanese food also represents characteristics of different ethnic groups. For instance, in Taipei, people can find various traditional Chinese restaurants, while in Hsinchu or Miaoli, Hakka food is the main cuisine. If you keep heading south to Tainan or Kaohsiung, Minnan dishes become daily food for a resident. Moreover, countless night market local delicacies are always impressive places for foreigner tourists to visit. Popular snacks like stinking tofu, oyster omelette, beef noodles, and pure milk tea are absolutely worth a try. In addition to the fascinating culture, futures, and gourmet, Taiwan also has some great achievements in technology. It is home of the largest bicycle company in the world, Giant. Next to it, it is home of the largest computer company in the world, Acer.
To sum up, Taiwan is a fantastic country with beautiful scenery, blended with tradition and modernity, Western and Eastern cultures. Foreigners are always welcome to explore this amazing island.
Welcome to
Taiwan!
11队演讲题目是 Number Two， 计时开始。
In recent years, Taiwan has been doing a great job in gaining visa privilege. Taiwanese passport holders now enjoy visa waivers, e-visas, or landing visas from 153 countries and territories, including the United States in 2012, Canada in 2010.Japan in 2014, and European Union in 2011. In October 2015, five more countries were added to the list: Kazakhstan, Tajikistan, Liberia, and Djibouti now grant Taiwan landing visa system, while Gabon in Africa includes Taiwan in its e-visa system. Next,I'll hand my microphone to Megan.
Thank you, Peggy. Visa waivers, landing visa, and visa privileges are significant to Taiwan in that they symbolize goodwill of and recognition by other countries. As far as tourism is concerned, visa exemption has encouraged prospective travelers to carry out the trip of their dream.According to the Tourism Bureau, The outbound travel population ratio in 2014 is 23%, compared to 21.6% in 2013. It saw a substantial increase of 1.4%. The increase may not be credited to visa privileges, but it does indicate Taiwanese people find great incentive to make overseas travel. Then, let's welcome Emily.
Thanks, Megan. As more and more Taiwanese people travel the globe on the wings of visa treatment, they will spontaneously make the country and culture known to the local people, prompting an official cultural exchange. I have a personal story to tell. In July 2015, my family and I went on a vacation to Germany. For us, traveling is all about making new friends and getting special experience. So, when we get there, we check into a hotel in Cologne and we struck up a conversation with the owner. He told us that Taiwan is truly a beautiful place. Well, we are surprised. And we ask him, did he ever been to Taiwan? Well, the answer is negative. But he then added that he saw Taiwan on a Discovery episode, and it was really impressive. So, we shared some aspects of modern Taiwan and invited him to pay a visit. This is a great experience and a good example of how favorable visa treatment can promote mutual understanding and make more foreigners to know Taiwan. Then, Bella, do you have something to add?
On the economic scale, the boom of Taiwanese tourists in those former visa-required countries has stimulated foreign business to heed the market of Taiwan. As a result, famous brands have opened their stores here, such as H&M, Uniqlo, and HiConnect, to name just a few. This has made Taiwan even more international. In conclusion, preferential visa status has enabled ROC citizens to undertake virtual diplomacy by going global more conveniently. It has also reaffirmed Taiwan's value and soft power. Way to go, Taiwan! 1, 2, 3.
Thank you for your attention.
第十队演讲题目是 Number One， 计时开始。
Good morning, judges and fellows.
英九吗 ？The president of Taiwan once said, "Taiwan has transformed from a humanitarian aid receiver into a humanitarian aid provider." In fact, not only the prosperous economic development in the 1980s, but the great help often from many foreign countries in some disasters such as the 9/11 earthquake, that have made more and more Taiwanese people devoting themselves into humanitarian aid activities. Meanwhile, our government is also actively engaging in numerous international humanitarian aid events and providing some assistance to the needed, such as permanent medical mission and reconstruction project in the aftermath of disasters. Speaking of permanent medical mission, our government focuses on particular regions where the medical services are especially scarce. They have sent lots of personnel to underdeveloped countries in order to spread the medical mission and recruit the chronic lack of medical human resources. Our government recently operates permanent medical mission in Burkina Faso. In order to combat against the diseases, our government offered humanitarian aid to Africa for the Ebola epidemic. Now let's invite Sunny to give us more details.
Thanks, Katie. Taiwan now established medical facilities like hospital and set up basic hygiene equipment like sewer and system for water purifying. By doing so, the amount of debt decreased dramatically. Therefore, the standard of living raises. People there don't have to worry about whether the food or water is clean enough or not. Humans around the world should have a basic standard living condition no matter where they live.
more devastating than diseases. Sometimes disaster can completely ruin areas. The poverty and death rate increases well after the disasters. At this time, humanitarian aid such as financial support, rescue team, and daily necessities suffer essential. Only 2 days after the 311 earthquake in Japan, our government donated $100 million in order to help Japan. On the third and fourth day, two rescue teams, a 35-member civilian organized team, and a 28-member Ministry of Interior team were dispatched to Sendai and other affected areas. This team played a key role during the process of reconstruction. Now let's have Amy to continue the speech.
Thanks, Sunny. At the same time, Taiwanese gathered money and consumer to aid the Japanese. With that help, the Japanese soon recovered from the disaster, which elicited great appreciation from the people. Not only the government, but the general public in Taiwan and Japan has a stronger bond since then. As for our Taiwanese teenagers, though we don't have much influence on these international issues, we still play an important role as volunteers when our government is putting projects into practice in areas. For instance, over 627 Taiwanese teen volunteers have served with the Taiwan ICZF Overseas Volunteer Services, offering assistance in 37 countries. These teen volunteers work with several sectors like education, agriculture, public health, and so on. These teen volunteers work with local residents, not only citizen diplomacy is put into practice. When some severe disaster happens, our Taiwanese teenagers can not only help physically, but spiritually. Some victims will be depressed after the disaster happened, especially when their relatives died. Now let's invite Tony to give a conclusion for us.
Thanks, Amy. At this time, emotional support serves as the best medicine for their sorrow. What we can do is listen to the victims and bring much comfort. Our teenager can accompany those victims to get through the difficult period of time and face the struggle ahead in a positive way. Our government endeavors to provide emergency relief and assistance in the aftermath of natural disasters, wars, and deadly disease spreading, either in our partner countries or elsewhere in the world. They also build a partnership with some international NGOs to carry out humanitarian projects. As one of the responsible members in the Global Village, Taiwan could not stand aside and do nothing, said President Ma. We're now living in a global village, which means that everything happening in the world is now interconnected with us. It's our duty to help those in need and bring safety and happiness to their life. Let's do our best to provide humanitarian assistance and make the entire world become better.
Thanks for your listening.
第九队演讲题目是 Number 5, 计时开始。
Good morning, fellow competitors and distinguished judges. Nowadays, the world shrinks beneath our feet as information zooms around the world at a more rapid pace than the day before. How many times have you felt left out of the loop? Confused with current events when you thought you have read up enough the night before? Information is instant these days, as it is possible to see live news feed of a war taking place thousands of miles away. These events may alter our point of view, it may have an influence in our opinion, and it may play an important role in our future decisions. In the last 100 years, technology has grown exponentially to a point where it is extremely exciting to see where it goes in the future.
And nowadays, we can get information very easily, like getting cookies from a cookie jar. These cookie jars can be YouTube's, on the newspapers, or BBC, or even CNN. However, the informations are not just only the articles we read that are helpful, but the films and the music we listen to. As the digital cameras allows film producing methods, people can put in their insights and even cultures into the movies. There are festivals and websites to produce movies and films. As the information spread widely around the world, we can see different cultures from the six continents around the world.
That's right. In Taiwan, we are fortunate enough to have several international schools and students with whom we can sit down and talk about certain issues in various
There are a handful of other ways to get to know what's happening around the world. Other media resources and online resources have provided us great and convenient ways to know what's happening around the world. Take what just happened in Paris on Friday, for example. People have started trends about Pray for Paris, also praying for the whole world as soon as possible, and sending help, food, and care around. That being said, we should be careful and take responsibility when viewing screens and articles. This is the era of the internet, and it is important for us to keep in mind that as a global citizen, we should always know that we should identify what's right and what's not, to know that under this so much of information, we should keep in mind that as a global citizen, we should always digest and know what is wrong or not, and
Thank you for listening. 第八队演讲题目是 Number 5, 计时开始。
Honorable judges, good morning. How would you express your approval of something? Most of us will nod our heads, right? Well, if we do that in India, local people may not understand what we mean.We would have to bobble our heads from left to right like this to show our agreement. Here's something more serious. In most cases, it should be fine if we extend our hands with our palms out to show refusal, right? In Greece, however, it is considered the rudest gesture we can ever make. Now that doesn't sound too nice. So,We have to know what gestures we can or cannot make in certain countries. And this is a simple reason why we should gain a global perspective. To understand other cultures and to avoid violating cultural taboos.
Why should we develop a global vision? Well, at least we won't run into trouble when visiting other countries. At most, it raises our personal competitiveness in the world. Therefore, we should try understanding how to develop a global perspective, and it isn't the hardest thing to do. By viewing programs or sites by the BBC, the National Geographic, or CNN,We can get a better picture of what is going on around the world from a global point of view. Besides, reading books by renowned authors can enrich our knowledge in specific topics. To widen our vision even more, we can establish pen pal relationships with foreigners through social media. Through conversation, communication, and interaction, it is easier to understand different cultures, different points of view and different aspects of many issues. Most importantly, these efforts do not cost us a lot of money.
Here's an example. The four of us heard the term BRICS, B-R-I-C-S. B, Brazil, R, Russia, I, India, and C, China, BRICS, in class and feels genuinely interested. So we decided to know more about Brazil. We surfed the internet to learn about Brazil's geography and history. We read books telling us about Brazil's economic status in the world. We met friends with a Brazilian blogger through a social website. All of this knowledge widened our understanding of not only Brazil, but also the whole world that it connects to. We have come to understand a little bit more about how Brazilians look at the world. We now know why Brazil is such an important economy in the global society. Moreover, we understand how similar Brazil is to us. The distance between us may be far, but in a globalized world, we are next to each other. We are the same.
As the chairman of Canon, Fujio Mitarai, said, diversification and globalization are the keys to the future. So, we live in a small world. Everything that happens around the globe, no matter how small, is more or less going to affect us. In the present world, many problems trouble us, such as global warming, worldwide pollution, and food shortage. These hazards threaten us and require all of us to care. Developing a global perspective does not just benefit a single person or a single nation. It is the key to global interdependency that would definitely be crucial when facing these difficulties. From the smallest part of understanding different cultures to facing international issues, every bit plays its part. On the other hand, we need to understand that everyone is the same in our global village. Through peace, harmony, and cooperation, nations shall someday join together in globalization and international partnerships. Thank you for listening.
第六队演讲题目是 Number One， 计时开始。
Good morning. Humanitarian aid is defined as a material assistance to alleviate suffering and maintain human dignity. Typically, in response to a crisis such as natural and man-made disasters. Taiwan has become a world leader providing humanitarian aid and was a major contributor to tsunami relief in Japan, earthquake relief in both Haiti and Nepal. Taiwan is also a provider to long-term crises as seen in providing solar powered lamps to refugee camps for people displaced by a civil war in Africa. How can Taiwanese youth play a major part in humanitarian effort? We can be part of the first response relief teams. Join local community groups focused on providing international humanitarian aid and by being personally responsible and knowledgeable. My friend Enpei will tell us more.
Thank you, Michelle. Youth can take the initiative and join international groups such as the Red Cross and UNICEF that send relief teams to areas in crisis. Approximately 50% of the Red Cross volunteers around the world are young people. Taiwanese youth can contribute to relief teams by delivering medical supplies and rebuilding homes and schools. Young participants can work to ease victim suffering and offer psychosocial support to their peers and community members. When Typhoon Haiyan struck the Philippines, 16 million people were affected. 4 million people were displaced, and 1 million homes were damaged or destroyed. In hopes of lending the people a helping hand, Taiwanese youth were there to distribute water and deliver hot meals and packages.
Students provided individuals with health and hygiene information, in addition to daycare and counseling for children. My friend Yvonne will elaborate further.
Thank you, Mpei. Taiwan's young people were key contributors. International volunteering is one way to get involved. However, not everyone is able to be involved in distant lands. There are many other ways to become involved. Local community programs provide an opportunity to Taiwan's young people to have an impact on international humanitarian aid. Youth may lack experience and money, but we do have enthusiasm. Local groups and organizations that focus on humanitarian aid can channel young people's enthusiasm to help in disaster preparedness, participating and organizing local activities to raise both money and awareness for humanitarian issues. For instance, the 30-hour famine activities across Taiwan are organized by Taiwanese youth to raise both money and awareness of long-term famine in many parts of the world. My friends and I plan on participating. So, even if you can't travel abroad, you can still contribute. My friend Sophia will tell us more.
Maybe you're like me. I become involved by being aware of what is happening around the world. I keep up with Taiwan's humanitarian efforts and spread information through social media. By keeping my family and classmates informed about humanitarian crises, I discuss humanitarian issues with them. In addition to that, I participate in events, donate money, try to advocate for humanitarian causes, and connect to those who want to make a difference. There are many ways the young people can contribute, either directly as members of emergency teams or as fundraisers for awareness events. Each should do what they're able to do. In conclusion, youth can become involved internationally, locally, and personally, despite the differences in their backgrounds.
Thank you.
第三队演讲题目是 Number Two， 计时开始。
Ladies and gentlemen, people of Taiwan are always looking for places to expand their education and business. Many students want to study abroad, but don't know exactly where they want to go. With the visa waiver program, students have the opportunity to travel to many countries around the world to experience different cultures and languages. They can have a wider view of the world. They can also visit potential countries where they want to attend universities. Once the students gain knowledge from the field of study, they can bring that back to Taiwan to make the economy boom and be on par with the rest of the world. Excuse me. To expand Taiwan's economy, companies now have the opportunity to expand their businesses worldwide. With the visa waiver program, companies can easily market their products on an international level. They don't have to rely on getting business from China anymore. Next, I would like to have Diana to tell us more about the USA's visa waiver program.
Thank you, Zoe. On March 2, 2012, the United States of America announced that any Taiwanese passport holders can participate in the visa waiver program. Under the program, all Taiwan citizens under the right requirements will be able to travel to the United States for business or tourism for 90 days or less without obtaining a visa. With this program, more students from Taiwan will be able to travel abroad and broaden their horizon. After the 911 incidents, the United States of America has been really strict on giving out the visa program to foreign countries. Despite the fact, Taiwan has been one of the few countries that was given the privilege 14 years later after the incident, which explained that it is a huge step for Taiwan to build an international trust with the United States of America. With this being said, we believe that more countries are going to offer Taiwan the visa waiver privilege. In other words, young people in Taiwan will have the opportunity to access a larger platform of knowledge, culture, and experience. Next, Safina would like to tell us more about the pros and cons of the visa waiver program.
Thank you, Diana. Many of us might wonder, what kinds of benefits do we obtain from visa waiver and landing visa programs? Well, these benefits are so great that countries from all over the world are signing agreements among one another. Well, visa waiver not only benefits the traveler from designated countries, but also provide the given country a boost in economy. Let us provide you with some examples. First, leisure travelers are able to make a trip to places that offer diverse and different cultural experiences with the passport of their own countries. Next, business travelers are able to fly across the globe to seek for potential markets and the possibility of expanding their businesses. Finally, student travelers have their opportunity to immerse themselves in a native speaking environment and take advantages of it to improve themselves. On the other hand, countries offering visa waiver could benefit from capital brought into their domestic economy, hence creating job opportunities. Developing a stronger and multicultural nation and build up a worldwide reputation. In other words, it's a win-win situation for both parties. Next, Tina would like to tell us about Taiwan's passport.
Thank you, Safina. With this green passport, Taiwanese citizens have visa-free or visa access to 129 countries and territories, ranking our passport 28th in the world. We are incredibly proud that our government values the importance of traveling abroad and has been aggressively taking part in negotiating and signing agreements with many countries around the world. Accessibility can be crucial and a great support from the government to its people to become global citizens. As youth, we are proud and we can take advantage of this opportunity and make good use of the visa waiver program. Nowadays, our competition is no longer just a classmate or youth in Taiwan, but youth around the world. Enabled to compete with them, we need to step out of our comfort zone to gain experiences, learn from other leading countries, and improve Taiwan's different industries. In this case, visa waivers are great tools that allow us to be a bigger part of the world that we are living in. We are proud to be Taiwanese. With the visa waiver program, we are able to show the world that we are not just a small community. We are a big part of this global family. Thank you.
Number 2, 计时开始.
Communication is an essential part of diplomacy. This begins by starting and growing meaningful relationships, and this can be difficult when people are hundreds or thousands of kilometers away. Taiwan's uncommon place in the international community makes it hugely important for us to reach out to people around the world. Our government has worked hard to increase the number of countries that extend visa privileges to us, and we have seen such work this year. More countries have granted our citizens such privileges, and this past summer, the United States took part in renewing the visa waiver program. In fact, Taiwan's passport has one of the most improved world ratings in the last 10 years. This is great news for our people because this can help mutual understanding, allow relations to develop, and give all countries the chance to share and grow together.
Did you know the name Hei-Timis, Land of Mountains? Or that the world's largest and oldest market is in Turkey. In Peru, there is a canyon almost twice as deep as the Grand Canyon. Peru even has the oldest university in the Americas. Knowing the basic elements of the world around us can give us the foundation needed to learn new and interesting things. Hearing that Kazakhstan has a navy doesn't sound very interesting,
unless you already knew that Kazakhstan is a landlocked country. With the development of travel and homestay services, going overseas has become easier and cheaper. Of course, going through a visa process can sometimes be complex. And if difficulties arise, the additional stress means everything becomes more difficult for the traveler. Losing a passport or needing specific documents are common occurrences. Without visa agreements between countries, overcoming these problems can become much more difficult. It isn't hard to see how the adding simplicity to such a process is hugely valuable. When visa privileges are attained from other countries, it becomes easier for people to discover and learn about the world around us.
Technology has come a long way and allows us to connect with people around the world. We can buy clothes, cars, and even groceries from a computer. Yet we still have shopping malls. We want to ask questions before buying something big, and talking to our family on Skype is hardly a substitute for actually going home for a holiday. Face-to-face contact is still the best way to start, foster, and maintain relationships. It's also the best way to persuade others, because there's so much we want to tell the world about this island. Having visa privileges makes doing this much easier. Taiwan has a stable population, defined territory, sound government, and ability to enter into relations with other states. Together, these qualities put us in a great position to establish and foster relationships with people around the world. Bring or delivering goods, holding a trade show, or conducting research. These can be difficult tasks in some countries, and therefore, permits may be needed. Good relations with countries and peoples around the world can give Taiwan a good foundation of so many areas of society. It means future goals for us do not need to rely on one or two diplomatic partners.
When people are able to come together, work together, and grow together, relationships are built. And of course, the same is true for countries. A solid relationship can come from many things, including frequent communication, mature understanding, and overcoming difficulties. This relationship can be built because Taiwan is in a great position to share with the world our scientific, technical, and even democratic expertise. This knowledge can be hugely beneficial to some countries, resulting in leaders coming here to learn and see what we do. Taiwan is also attractive because, unlike some countries, we have an unrestricted flow of information, and only within the environment of democracy does innovation thrive. Taiwan can offer an environment that is great for creativity and innovation. We can see this today with science, art, and industrial parks all over the island. Having visa privileges makes it easier for our people to establish and grow the kinds of relationships that can bring people here. The world is constantly changing, and having good relationships around the world can help ensure Taiwan's future for the next generation.
Wow.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
I'm really happy to be here. To be the judges. I enjoy it a lot. Of course, it's a very difficult job at the same time, since the teams today are all excellent, so it's really very difficult for us to make the decision who gonna be the top six. But we still have to try our best. I'm gonna give you some feedback according to the grading category, all right? The first, English ability and pronunciation. Basically, I think the teams today, they all quite good in this area in terms of fluency, enunciation, pronunciation, intonation. So I should say congratulations to teachers and students for your good effort and good job. The second category, content. This is a group speech, so it should conform to the format of a good speech. In other words, it need to have a very good structure, introduction, body, and then conclusion. And all those elements should be relevant to the topic you chose or you pick. I'd like to share my personal views to the content because we want to promote Taiwan to our international friends. I would prefer people not to patronize too much. What do we mean by patronize? You don't act like you are superior and you are someone to provide. Of course, we use provide, but it can mean something not very good. So you need to be careful. As a provider, you still have to be very humble, and you are also someone who gain, not just by giving, you also gain something from that. So maybe we should have the attitude that we are here to help, not to patronize. That would be maybe more suitable, I guess. And the other thing is try not to preach too much, to tell people what you should do, what you should not do, because I guess most of us or most of our friends abroad, they are all very knowledgeable, so we don't have to teach them what you should do or what you shouldn't do, right? So we need to share our care. So by sharing our care, we care about people, but we don't want to preach what they should do or what they shouldn't do, all right? And the most important thing is we want to promote Taiwan, we want to advertise Taiwan, so be careful not to do something that have the opposite effects, okay? Finally, you have to be careful about the information you include in your speech. It has to be correct. Otherwise, the total score will suffer. Oh, finally, stage manner. Well, this is a tough one because we get nervous when we stand here and have a lot of people watching us, right? So it need practice. You need to get used to talk in public. I think most teams today, they show very good stage manner. And some tips for better stage manner would be remember that this is a teamwork. So showing support to your teammates by deliver every part of your speech is important. And pay attention, you are attentive to your teammates is also something we will consider important. And transition from speaker to speaker, you need to probably come up with some idea how do you do that, but not too much, right? Sometimes the key is do something, but don't overdo that, right? Gestures, we have many speakers using hand gesture, but again, sometimes speakers tend to overdo their hand gesture, and it gives the feeling that it's not quite natural. So you need to probably relax more when you deliver your speech. If you relax more, then we relax too. If you get nervous, we get nervous too. So if you can try to relax and naturally bring your hands or bring your eye contact with the audience, then that would be perfect. You don't need to come up with all kind of different gesture when you speak, because in normal circumstances, people don't do that, right? But of course, in public speaking, we try to do a little bit more to persuade people. But if you do more than enough, that will also bringing some negative effects. Okay, so remember, do something, but don't overdo that, right? Okay, I guess that's about all. Thank you for your performance today. I enjoy it a lot, and I hope you have a wonderful future. If you get to be selected to represent our country to promote Taiwan. All right, that's all. Thank you.